Turner Falls Park trout fishing.
Okay, we filled up the gas tank, got some coffee, got some breakfast of champions, some donuts, so we should be ready to go and hit the road, and hopefully here in about an hour and a half, we'll be on the river at Turner Falls Park. Wish us luck.
Okay, give you an idea of where they stocked the trout today, where we went fishing. We marked off the spots. What you'll see is there's one spot right here where there's a little parking area, and that's where they stock trout, and you'll see it in the pictures that we'll show, where there's some a dam, as well as where we caught some of these fish initially. And then there's another area here that was stocked, and then further downriver you'll see this area where there's a bunch of parking, or at least an area to park, and actually some camping areas as well, and they stocked that section as well. And we'll show that in the video as well.
Brought the six-weight switch rod and got the near deer and gold-rooted hares here nymphed set up. And, what we're going to do is just kind of work this one area that we had caught some before, and then just work our way down river. All right, here's one of the dams. We'll see if we can peek over here and see if there's anything, and then we'll keep moving up river. All right, we can see trout in the water moving about, so let's see if we can get one to hit. We got a hook up on the orange and white near deer. Steady pull, or actually it's a fast retrieve. All right. Cool beans, our first fish of the day. We got our first one of the day on the orange and white near deer. They're out here in this pool. And the retrieve that we're using is just basically quick pulls of the line. There's a hit right there. Very nice. Oh yes. Oh, and that's a jump too. Beautiful. All right. Oh yes. There we go. Oh shoot. All right. So fish number two. Since we don't know about the weather and all that, we're gonna go ahead and keep fish number two, and fish number two . Okay so that was two fish on the orange and white near deer, short retrieves. We're gonna keep those two, and then we're gonna be picking with these next three. It's a five fish limit here at the park. You can see another school going by here. There's a hit. All right. Hit that one on the move. At the tail end of the retrieve, as we're getting closer, we just kind of start shaking it, and we get them to take. Why we love the park is you get these guys, but we have definitely seen some bruisers out here, probably around the 16, 18 inch range. Already, so hopefully we can get one of those guys. Okay, just give you a layout of where we're at in one of our Google videos. You'll see two dams. This is the first dam that's upriver, and then the second one's over here, and then it'll go down to the waterfall area. And this one pool is where we're catching them right now. We've caught them up that way before, and we've caught them that way as well, past this one shallow area, some runs. But bottom line, water's very clear. You can definitely see the fish in the water, and with those albinos or orange ones that are chasing the fly, it's helping out being able to locate some of the schools. And there's a splash over there, so there are fish here. Got them. All right. It's a jumper. And like we were saying, we're just yanking away, getting this switch rod, getting the cast that we want, and getting them out there. That's a nice one. Beautiful. Cool beans. Stuck a trout, baby. Gotta love them. Oh, this one came off the hook. All right. Cool beans. Here's the upper part of that dam we were talking about, and we're just looking in the pool, seeing if we see any movement. Bottom line, we saw them a lot that way, downriver. And here we're just kind of looking around just to see, not near as much excuse me, not near as much water as there was last time we were here, Of course, there was a lot of flooding last year, so this year it looks like things have kind of settled down.
All right, we're starting to see some of the albinos again. So where the albinos are, there'll be the other ones also. So I'm gonna give this spot a try. Count one, two, looks like three albinos in this pool. So let's see what happens. All right, we move further downstream and we can see some activity here. So we're gonna see if we can get something here.
You can actually see them chasing our fly. So that's a good thing. Got him. All right, there we go. Very nice. All right, cool beans.
So the temp started dropping. We can see some mist coming off the water. Decided to start catching and keeping.
Well, we've gotten basically a limit, but we let go of some. So we're gonna end up keeping this little guy because, well, our mojo's off. All right, it's been brutal, but we got number four that we'll keep. There's number five after a lot of hard work at getting them. We're done, but we're going to try this water wolf camera to see if we can get a picture of that bruiser that's hanging out over here.
And we definitely spied a bruiser earlier, but when we put the water wolf camera in the water, all we saw were these little guys, scrappy ones. Here's an albino, and you'll see leave another albino one that'll be in the water over there hiding. And this is just right off one of the runs. And then this is further up the pool. You can see out in the distance a lot of the trout that were hanging out there. And there's a picture of the today's catch. All right, till next time, we'll catch y'all there, and good luck and good fishing.